Good evening, everyone. Welcome to another edition of Behind the Mic with yours truly, BK Swedish Music. Apologies for the late start. Having some technical difficulties, I had to revert back to using my phone as my camera. My camera decided to not cooperate with me, but the show must go on. So, good evening, everyone. Nads, Auntie Rose, It's Flame the DJ, That Boy Chur, IQ Remix. What's going on, family? Happy to see you, the early crew. Hope you guys are well and having a wonderful Saturday. Let's see here. Make sure I can hear myself. Okay, here we go. All right, so let me set myself up. I just got a little disheveled there. Sorry, guys. So as you can tell from the banner below me, tonight's show we are going to focus on Cece Winans, one of the Winans sisters, the more famous Winans sisters, I should say. There are others, but she's the more pronounced one. Let's just rewind, start from the top. All right, so my sound is, I don't know what's going on with my focus right now, but once again, good evening, happy Saturday to everyone in the chat, to my lurkers and silent participants. Hope you're well. And let's get this show on the road with Cece Winans, shall we? All right, so Cece Winans. Her correct name, or her legal name, I should say, is Priscilla Marie Winans. If you guys remember, from the top of the month, I went through the chronological order of the Winans family. So she is legally known as Priscilla Marie Winans Love, but professionally she is known as Cece Winans. And she began her music career by first singing with her brother, Benjamin, but we know him better as BB Winans. So the duo, they were known professionally starting out as BB and Cece Winans. And afterwards, she then launched her solo career. So if you guys were here last week, I did touch a bit on them when they started out on the PTL show, and they had the song, the famous song, Lord Lift Us Up. And that's pretty much where they got their start, respectively. And then from there, they went into their own separate solo careers and then came back together again, so forth and so on, right? So tonight. And then in 1998, she released her second album called Everlasting Love, which became certified gold. And it featured her highest charting singles called Well Alright and Slippin'. Those are the name of the songs, respectively. And fun fact on her single from the same album called On That Day was written and produced by R&B singer Lauryn Hill. So if you guys weren't aware of that, that's a little fun fact for you. And I think I have mentioned this before in the prior episodes of the series, where the Winans have a way of doing crossovers from gospel into R&B, and they have a lot of featured artists from the secular world, if you will, that would come in on different singles, and pretty much it would be a success. I said I wanna see you.
Some of us living in insanity.
Definitely that point, I agree with what you just said there, where she's been able to take the secular modern approach and appeal it to the gospel crowd and do it successfully and not really have anyone make a big stink about it, And like I said before, I think I said this last week, it's definitely a gift or an anointing that the Winans family as a whole has. They've all been able to successfully do that. All of them. So it's really cool. It's really, really cool. If you will, audio ambassadors, I see you just came in. Good evening, sir. Welcome. Happy. And I made a mistake and said happy Saturday. See, habit is a bad thing sometimes. Happy Sunday. My whole technical difficulties threw me off there. But happy Sunday, everyone. Audio ambassadors, good evening. Hope you're well. Thanks for joining us. What you mean, audio? You still use a VCR. Whatever. But yeah, NADS is the acronym. Come on now. We know it's food, but it's the acronym. But yes, once again, you know, she's like definitely experimenting with her sound and showing how versatile gospel music is, right? And can be. You know, it's not just the traditional hymns. It's a little R&B. It's a little a little rock and roll, if so to speak. You know, it's a little bit of a more of a hip hop type feel. It's a little bit of things, but what's most important is the message behind it, right? That's the most important thing with gospel. It's good news, right? So, yes, exactly, Naz. The Winans definitely made gospel cool and just, like, really uplifting, feel-good music. I mean, you can throw on any one of their songs at any given point in time. You don't necessarily have to feel down, but if you feel down, throw on a Winans song. I bet you before that song is over, you would feel so much better. Also, I have an announcement for you guys. This will be my last show for 2022. I'm going to take a break and take some time off away from streaming for a bit, and I'll return in 2023. So I just want to thank you guys for rocking with me for this 6 months that I've been streaming. You know, it's been a roller coaster ride, but I thank you guys for being with me on the ride and encouraging me every single week. But yeah, definitely girls gotta take a break and just kinda take a step back and recalibrate, you know, and I'll see you guys in 2023. So thank you guys once again. Thank you to my lovely moderator, Nads. Thank you to That Boy Jer. Thank you to IQ Remix, Chico, Audio, you know, all of you guys who have been rocking with me all the time, every week. And you guys have a wonderful and blessed holiday season. You know, make sure you guys be safe, of course. Be healthy, you know, and just remember what's most important in life, you know. I don't know, with all these different sales and things going on, it's easy to get caught up in all of that conundrum, but you know, just really focus on what's most important. And Behind the Mic will return in 2023. I will just leave one assignment with you guys while I am away. I ask that you guys, you know, continue to go in the past episodes and create your highlights of whatever, you know, points in time that you found was a highlight for you, that you found meaningful or brought you joy or what have you, just to keep the vibes going. And once again, anyone who stumbles across the page who doesn't understand the nature of the show, that they, you know, get that.